So, Heather, I'll start with you. As we look at these huge opening weekend matchups, which of these teams can least possibly afford to lose this opener?
Notre Dame, 100%. And that's because in the selection committee meeting room, any team that does not win its conference championship, and Notre Dame doesn't have one, has to face a higher burden of proof. So if Notre Dame loses, even if they run the table and they finish as a one-loss team, that means on selection day that they have to be better than, unequivocally better than, any other one-loss Power 5 champion. I mean, think about that. One loss Bama, one loss whatever it is, Ohio State, which would have the head-to-head win against them. That is a really tough bar to face, and ESPN's FPI projects that Notre Dame will win each of its remaining games except for Clemson. So if that's the case, then they are bye-bye, but they've got to win this one.
So, Paul, you were here yesterday, and you were telling us you think Notre Dame is overranked at number 5 in the AP preseason rankings. So let's dive into that. Do you believe the Irish take a step forward or a step backward this year?
I think they step back a little bit, Greeny, and it's not anything in particular because I think Marcus Freeman is off to a really great start. He is recruiting at an epic level. The problem is, he's never been a head coach before, and I know Notre Dame fans think they got rid of a bum in Brian Kelly. He was only the winningest coach in Notre Dame history. Think about that for a second. He was a phenomenal coach, but Brian Kelly didn't think he could recruit at a high enough level at Notre Dame to win it all. He could get to the playoff, and then he would always lose. Marcus Freeman is recruiting well enough, but we don't know whether he is Brian Kelly. I don't think he is right now. He looked terrible in the bowl game when they blew a big lead, and he's probably, well, forget probably, he is definitely going to lose his opener against Ohio State. And Notre Dame fans can scream and holler, but they're all wrong. They let a really great coach go to LSU in Brian Kelly, and now it's a matter of whether Marcus Freeman can step up.
Well, look, I mean, Paul, at least in the projection of this, is right. Ohio State is a 14.5-point favorite in that game. So, Heather, I guess I would ask the question, are we comparing Ohio State to Notre Dame, or dare I say, is Ohio State actually on equal footing with Alabama?
Right this skinny minute, you better believe they are. I mean, when you're talking about the talent on those two teams, 100%. That's why I have Ohio State number one in my preseason poll. If you're talking big picture, coaching, playoff appearances, dynasty, national titles, yes, it's Alabama, right? Ohio State hasn't gotten there yet under Ryan Day. But when these two teams meet, and I'm going to say that they will in the college football playoff, then we're going to see just how close they are. But you're talking about talent, these two quarterbacks, Bryce Young, C.J. Stroud. You're talking about defensively, I think they have the talent. They match up. I hope that we see these two teams play and they settle it on the field.
So Ohio State number one and Alabama number two. Paul, I don't know how that would fly with the callers on your talk show this afternoon, but is she right?
Yeah, she is, and I hate to admit that because, I mean, Heather's the brainiac of this duo, and she really spit out some really good facts right there. And I almost want to believe her and agree with her, but I can't. By contract, I can't say anybody but Alabama. You know the deal, Greeny. But I think this is, assuming Alabama gets there, and I think they will, this is going to be a different game than 2 years ago in the COVID year when Alabama won that game by 28 points.
Quickly, Paul, let me ask you about a different SEC team, and that is the defending champions, Georgia. We see they will open with Oregon. Is the world sleeping on them this year? They've sent, it felt like, half their roster to the pros in the NFL draft. Is the world sleeping on the Bulldogs this year?
And that's the problem, Greeny. Yeah, they're sleeping a little bit because the defense is just not going to be the same. Now, what a ridiculous statement that is, considering what we watched and what you broadcast in Vegas a couple of months ago. The offense is going to be better. Stetson Bennett is back. He was the walk-on who became the Disney movie piece last year by leading them to a national championship. But the defense is going to take a step backwards. And also, the defensive coordinator from last year, Dan Lanning, he'll be coaching for Oregon in that opener.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.